Welcome back to Chemistry Matters, Unit 7, where we're looking at ways in which we can take concentrated solutions and dilute them to a specified molarity. Since our last video on this playlist, you should have not only made a plan for executing the dilution lab and gotten it approved by your teacher, but by now you should have completed the lab, under your teacher's supervision, of course. So let's get back to our classroom to see how our students' plans and results compare to yours.
Let's begin with each team describing their plan so I can approve it before you create your dilutions. You two can go first.
Okay. We solved V1 and calculated that we'll need 16 milliliters of the copper 2 nitrate solution, which is the stock solution. So we plan to measure that with our 25 milliliter graduated cylinder. Since that's the smallest cylinder that we can use to measure that amount.
Yeah, that way we'll know we're getting the most precise measurement we can get.
Then we'll pour that into the 100 milliliter volumetric flask.
Our next step will be to add distilled water to the volumetric flask until the solution reaches the 100 milliliter mark.
Lastly, we'll cap it and mix it.
Sounds like a good plan. How about you two?
Well, we solved for V1 and calculated that we'll need 5 milliliters of the copper 2 nitrate solution, which is the stock solution, which we can measure with our 10 milliliter graduated cylinder.
Right, so we'll put that into the 100 milliliter volumetric flask and add distilled water until the solution reaches the 100 milliliter mark.
Then, just like the other team, we'll cap it and shake it so we know it's well mixed.
Okay. Both teams have put together excellent plans. Go ahead, put on your safety glasses and get started on your dilutions.
Okay, let's add the copper 2 nitrate solution to the 25 milliliter graduated cylinder. Be careful not to overshoot it.
Yeah, let's put about 16 milliliters in it.
Hold. Okay, a little bit more. Right there. All right. Okay, I'll pour it into the 100 milliliter volumetric flask.
Okay.
Can you hold that? All right. Hold that for me. Okay.
Okay, now let's add the distilled water to the flask. We have to make sure we fill it exactly to the line, so be careful.
I'll put in 5 milliliters of the copper 2 nitrate solution that we made earlier with a pipette.
All right, I'll pour that into the 100 milliliter volumetric flask, and then you can add the distilled water up to the mark, okay?
Sounds good. Ready? Okay, now get low and make sure you're watching.
Man, that's a cool color.
Yeah, it's definitely more diluted now than it was before. I mean, look at how much lighter the color blue is.
Kat and Josh, why did your group need so much less stock solution than the other group?
Well, our final solution concentration was a lot lower than the other group's, but we made the same volume of solution, 100 milliliters.
Their final molarity was 0.08, while ours was only 0.005. Since our final molarity was so much lower than theirs, we didn't need as much stock.
Yeah, so it would make sense that we wouldn't need as much of our stock solution in order to complete the dilution.
Great job, and great reasoning, too.
By now, you should see that in order to make a concentrated solution more dilute, all it really takes is a target volume and concentration, some careful math calculations, and the appropriate glassware. Keep practicing those mass percent, molarity, and dilution calculations. And I'll see you at the top of the next video on the Unit 7 playlist, where we'll talk about another measure of concentration, the effects that solutes can have on solutions. And we'll demonstrate a lab I'm pretty sure you're going to like.